Previously on Get Real.
He's here. He found my address. He tracked me down.
Good news, Amy found another recruit.
And I promised by Saturday night to you, I forgot to clear it with my boyfriend.
Came to find out if you feel the same way I do. Okay, good answer.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm just exhausted. Maybe I'm coming down with something. Oh, God.
Yourself.
I thought we should talk.
About us?
Is there an us?
He's got a girlfriend, you know.
What are you talking about?
Denial. That's one way to go. Okay, so you've got a bad for him, and he's dating your best friend. Very Melrose.
It's not funny.
So why don't you just go after him? I mean, if there's anything real between Clay and Amy, he wouldn't be into you.
No, no, it's not that simple.
It is from where I sit.
Yeah, well, Amy's not your friend.
Okay. How about I steal Clay from Amy, dump him a week later, and you swoop in and pick up the pieces?
Well, that's... sweet, but no thanks. I think I just need to forget about Clay.
Good idea. Put yourself out there, meet new guys.
Oh yeah, brave words coming from someone who hides out in the girls' bathroom.
Well, a little attitude. I think that's worthy of an invite. Here, we'll go together.
A rave? No, didn't Vince Gilligan get hospitalized after that rave last year?
Yeah, because he tried to pierce his tongue with his car keys. I think we're a little smarter than that.
So your blood work came back fine. Your blood pressure's normal. You're in excellent health. I don't foresee any problems.
How do you feel?
Awful. Tired. And beyond tired. I don't ever remember it being this bad before.
Well, you're not 18 anymore.
Any morning sickness?
Little.
I keep craving instant mashed potatoes, which I hate, and I keep thinking I smell smoke.
Phantom smells. I wouldn't worry too much about that. There's the heartbeat. You see it?
Yeah.
Now we can make a videotape of this. You want a copy for your husband?
I think I'd better tell him first.
I'd just like to take a moment to thank you for taking the time to teach me to drive.
You're welcome. Although I wasn't planning on devoting my life here. Start the car.
Just like that? No lecture? No mission control checklist?
Are you nervous?
Me? Nervous? No, of course not. Are you kidding?
Ignition?
Right, igniting.
Hey, Green! I was gonna go do some shopping for our history project. You need some more vinyl in your wardrobe.
History project?
Oh, never mind. I'll take you driving some other time, okay?
Yeah.
Okay, are you sure? You're fine with
that? Yeah, it's okay. Have fun.
Thank you.
Wow. You get to eat like this all the time?
Daddy's club, daddy's little girl.
I can get used to this. Can you get out of the house next weekend?
Next weekend? I don't know. That's 8 days away.
But you don't have plans?
Not that I know of.
Good. Then I'm booking you.
Which day?
Any day that you can sneak out. You know what? You better pencil me in for the following weekend, too.
What are we doing?
I don't know. Just want to make sure we're together. What are you doing tonight?
You never quit, do you? I'll meet you back here at 5 o'clock.
5 o'clock.
What's this?
Snagged it from my dad's cellar. It's so we can celebrate our multiple dates.
Mm. I can think of a lot better way to celebrate. Trust me when I say this. You need to send the electrician down again. All right. I'll be here. Thanks.
Lunch?
Hey, honey. I'm sorry, I already ate. I was just about to... What's wrong?
What? I have some interesting news.
Something happened to the car?
No.
The kids?
No, Mitch.
What then?
Do you remember the night driving home after the reunion?
And the car pulled over to the side of the road after?
Yeah.
In explicit detail?
I saw the doctor today.
Well? Oh.
Yeah.
Wow. I mean, how?
Want me to draw a picture?
No, I just... You know what I mean. I just... We're usually careful about that.
Well, we were a lot of things that night, Mitch, and careful wasn't one of them.
Well, so, the doctor said everything was okay?
Yeah.
Good. That's good.
That's what she said.
So, I guess we should tell the kids?
Yeah. Yeah, eventually, Actually, that's something I've been dreading all week.
Oh, sure. I wasn't meaning this second. Just all week. I thought you saw the doctor today.
I did, but I did a home test, you know, just to be sure, because they're not totally accurate.
Well, they're like 99% accurate. Why don't you tell me sooner?
Well, what difference does that make now, Mitch?
Well, the difference is you've had a week to get used to this.
Well, is this something you need to get used to?
No, I just... Hey, look, if you're so well adjusted with this, why did you wait a week to tell me?
You mean so well adjusted? Mitch, I...
Is this a bad time?
No. No, I'm Laura. This is my wife, Mary. Mary, this is Laura Martinow, the project engineer.
It's nice to meet you. Mitch talks about you all the time.
Hi.
You know what? I can come back later.
No, it's... Please, I'm just leaving. All right, but I'll see you at home.
Yeah, no, tonight.
Nice to meet you. Yeah.
Okay. Okay. I'll walk in.
Okay.
You all right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Bye. Fake mashed potatoes? Well, since when do we eat fake mashed potatoes?
I was just in the mood for something a little different.
Hey.
Hello.
This is Jody. Mom, Grandma, Kenny.
Hi.
So, Jody and I have this history project on the Persian Gulf Crisis, and I was just gonna, like, stay over house tomorrow night and, you know, to get a head start and stuff.
Okay, fine.
Cool. Mom, what are you doing?
Do you smell that?
Need a noun.
Smoke. I smell smoke. What? I quit smoking when I was 9. Oh. Good.
The number you have reached is not in service at this time, and there is no new number.
Hey, Mr. Meta, sorry to bother you. I'm kind of worried. I think you should leave.
I was supposed to meet Alicia, and I can't reach her. I was just wondering, you know, if she's okay.
I told you to stay away from my daughter. You can leave now, or I can call security.
I need a driving lesson, and I need it now. I won't take no for an answer.
No.
I won't take no for an answer a second time, so remember that.
Megan?
Yeah?
When did you say you're gonna spend the night at Jody's? It was tomorrow night, right?
What's that?
Dad?
A rave.
Okay, just listen.
Megan, you are not going to a rave.
Looks like you're out of luck.
They're not talking to me, they're talking to her.
You're letting Cameron go?
No one's going to a rave, period.
Why?
Why? Because you're underage and it's dangerous.
What is up with every parent I know trying to keep their kids locked up in the house?
Oh, what are you complaining about? You just go wherever you want.
Hey, let's not use Cameron as an excuse, okay? He gets punished plenty.
Yeah, this isn't about me, all right? And this definitely is not about you. Prenatal, vitamin... Wait, no, prenatal. Not even. Who's pregnant? Mom?
Oh, my God.
Oh, this better be you.
Pam, can you come get me?
Where are you?
Alicia, tell me what happened.
My dad, he just went crazy. I don't know what to do. I want to get out of here. Can you come?
So I think we've covered the Historical Society. But if you know anyone over there, you might want to make a friendly call. Hello?
Oh, I don't know anybody.
You know what, why don't we call it a day, huh?
No. I want to keep working.
I am working. You are staring.
I'm sorry, I'm thinking about some things.
Anything you want to share?
My wife's pregnant.
Congratulations, wow.
Thanks.
So what's the problem?
I shouldn't be talking about this.
Yeah, you're right. Better hold it all inside.
No, I'm just questioning some things, you know, decisions I made. If I'd known about this, I might not have quit my day job. I sure as hell wouldn't have bought this place.
You can always sell.
Yeah, just never thought I'd be a father again. You know, you think you have your life planned out. I think you know how it's gonna be, and...
So you don't have ESP, Mitch. I always planned on having kids by now, but you know, things don't always work out the way you plan. It's life. You know this.
I know this. I love being a dad. I'm gonna love this baby with everything I am. It's just... Right now, if I had a choice, this wouldn't have been it.
Thank you so much.
What happened to you?
I don't even know. He just like flipped out.
What, so you ran away?
No, he sent me here.
What is this, like a boarding school?
It's rehab. Look, this is just another example of my father trying to control everything that I do. He's punishing me for seeing
you. So he sends you to rehab? That's insane.
He thinks you're a bad influence. Yesterday he found that bottle in my purse. He thought you gave it to me. I told him it was mine, but he didn't believe me. He never does. Look, I understand if you don't believe me, okay? But it's true.
Yeah, I believe you.
Thank you.
Megan. Megan, where are you going?
Jody's, as discussed.
Dressed like that? Look, Megan, please, this isn't just me trying to run your life here. This is a rave. People have died at these things. There are just too many variables here. Too many things can happen.
Not at Jody's.
Do you honestly expect me to believe that's where you're going?
Where's Cameron?
Look, if Cameron is at the rave, I will deal with him later. Right now, I'm talking to you. Oh, honey, look, I guess this being pregnant, whatever, has brought out this protective mother thing in full force.
And you can't believe that you would use getting pregnant by accident as a reason for me to listen to you.
Excuse me? I guess my mistake here was trying to be reasonable with you, since you seem to be completely incapable of reason. Look, Megan, can you honestly look me in the eye and tell me you're not going to that rave?
Be at Jody's.
Megan.
Megan! Why do they make these things so hard to find?
Well, the police tend to find them quicker with giant neon signs.
Look, this map is totally wrong.
We could stop looking and go home.
No, no way. I totally blew up my mother tonight. I'm not going home.
Megan, I know you're, like, totally into this I'm a badass scene, but it's just a party. Why do you care?
I just wanted to, like, go out and have fun and just forget about Clay and, like, everything. Yeah, it doesn't even matter, because I'm already dead no matter what time I go home, so I'm going to this party and I'm staying.
Ooh, angry teenager. How not original.
Okay, now you're sounding like my mother.
You know what my mother said to me when I left the house tonight? Hey, Joe, don't get pregnant. I mean, what kind of mother would you rather have?
Well, did she say she was going to the rave?
No, Mitch, but it wasn't that hard to figure out.
Can we call this Jody's mom?
Look, I don't even know Jody's last name.
Well, do we still have the flyer?
No, Mitch, we've been through this. I don't have it.
All right, well, this is great. We can't even control the kids we already have.
A little quieter out here.
Yeah.
Wouldn't worry. They're just blowing off steam. Your sister isn't helping.
I know. It's just, isn't having a baby supposed to be happy?
It is, and they will be. Things are changing. Everybody just needs time to get used to it.
I mean, I'm excited about being a big brother and stuff.
Did you let them know?
Not yet.
Stay close to me. I don't want anything to happen to you.
Nothing's gonna happen. I'm gonna find the bathroom. Don't move.
This isn't a rave. This is a prom. Half our school is here. How many people did you invite?
Yeah.
No clue, but I know I didn't invite him. Come on.
Sister, is he here with you?
Is it hot in here?
It's
hot.
Are you all right?
Okay.
It's okay.
Here we go. Over here. Cam is so great. He's so amazing.
Right, okay. Now listen, Alicia. Okay, I'm gonna get your stuff and then we're gonna go find Cam, okay? Okay? You just stay here.
No, I can take care of myself.
Yeah, I can see that.
Excuse me.
Megan! Hey! Does Mom know you're here?
She should by now.
Did you see Alicia?
You gotta get her out of here.
Where is she?
I don't know, but Cam, she's like really hammered.
She's what? No, I just saw her. She's fine.
No. I mean, maybe somebody like put something in her drink.
I can't believe her. I can't believe after all she said. All right. Help me find them. We're getting the hell out of here.
Okay. Megan! We're gonna, like, go. Are you ready? I can. You go. I'll get her out with my brother. What? Are you sure?
Hello? Hi, Laura. No, Mitch isn't... Well, you sure you don't need to speak with him? Yeah, we do have a lot going on right now. Bye.
That's the kids?
No, that was your project engineer. You told her I was pregnant?
What? Yeah.
Oh. And what else did you tell her, Mitch? Because that certainly didn't sound like congratulations. Oh, great. Please tell complete strangers intimate details of our private lives.
I'm not telling intimate details. It just came out.
Mitch, something important is happening to us. And I can't even get you to sit down for 2 seconds to talk about it.
Well, I don't know what to say to you, Mary.
Oh, but you do know what to say to Laura, huh?
I'm sorry I said anything, okay? I shouldn't have. You know, but maybe it was easier talking to somebody who wasn't involved emotionally. She can't get hurt by what I say, but you might.
Are you happy about this baby?
How can I answer that? There's no way I can answer that.
Try asking me.
Are you happy?
Part of me is. And part of me isn't, and I don't know what to do with that.
Go back inside.
Alicia, no. Come on. Let's go to my car for a second. You can take a nap. No. Ha. You gotta sit down. Put your legs in. I'm gonna go back in and get Megan. All right, Alicia. Alicia, wake up! Megan! All right, I'm coming back for her. Okay, what time is it?
20 minutes past their curfew.
No television, no allowance, no car, not even get to school. I don't care. Honey, you should go to sleep. I'll wait up.
Actually, for the first time in weeks, I am wide awake. The irony here is we are almost done with this. Just a few more years.
No more waiting up, worrying. We would have been alone with each other for the first time in 18 years.
Yeah. You know, selfish as this might sound, part of me was looking forward to being a couple without kids. You know, we never had a chance to do that.
I don't think that sounds selfish. I mean, we did kind of skip the whole newlywed thing, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, Mary, I feel like I have saved up so many things I wanted to do.
I mean, don't you feel like we're just getting to that part of our lives that we put on hold?
Yeah. How are we going to do this, Mitch?
I don't know. But we will. You and me.
You and me.
Alicia.
Are we home yet?
Alicia, no, this is your rehab place. Where do we go? In here? Alicia. Honey.
Alicia. I got you.
Daddy. I don't want to be here.
Look, I know, but I gotta go.
Where did you take her?
Just a party, a stupid party. I didn't think this was gonna happen.
You took a girl out of rehab to a party. What did you think would happen?
She said she was okay.
Alicia's an addict. She'll do anything to convince you that nothing's wrong.
I know now. I'm sorry.
Maybe I should have told you about her addiction. Part of me is still trying to protect her. This is a disease. Look, if you really care about her, the best thing you can do is just allow her to get better. She needs to be around people who can say no to her, and that isn't me, and surely that isn't you. I know. That look on your face, that feeling as if somebody just punched you in the gut because you believed, you trusted. That's me. That's me every day.
Crazy out there. Why don't you just let us take you home? I can't. I've got to find Cameron.
Look, why don't you just come with us? I don't think you should be here alone.
No, I'm not. I'm not. Cameron's around here somewhere. I'll talk to you tomorrow, okay?
Megan!
talk, okay? Get up, go into Cameron's room, get his ass out of bed. He has to come back and get me.
Megan, where are you?
Tell him I'm a couple blocks from the party near the Sixth Street Bridge. You got that?
Are you okay?
Kenny, do you have the address?
Sixth Street Bridge.
Don't worry, Megan. I'm all over it.
Oh, no. Where's Cameron? Okay. Car keys and the ignition. Oh, Ed. What are you doing up?
It's 2 a.m. Two of my kids are missing in action and the phone rang. What do you think?
Start talking right now.
Look, I am sorry that I disobeyed Mom, and I am sorry that you had to come and pick me up, but Mom was being totally irrational. You know how she gets about stuff. She just like control everything. You know, she's so hormonal.
No, Megan, that is not gonna fly this time.
Like, I don't even know what to say to you. You think you can justify this? You think anything you say is gonna change the fact that you not only disobeyed your mother, but you worried the hell out of her? When you were the last thing she needs to be worried about. You know, your mother would never say this, but of all the kids, you have always been the one that we could count on. And I don't know what happened, but you have changed, Megan. You're my daughter, and I love you, but right now,
because Mom's pregnant?
No, because you were wrong. Grow up and see the difference. Until you do, you're just a child. If it means anything anymore, I am disappointed in you. And you know, I don't think I've ever really been disappointed in you before.
We'll talk more about this in the morning.
Is she okay?
Well, outside of being grounded till she's 30, yeah, she's okay.
Remember this house being so quiet.
Creepy, isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, I wouldn't worry. We got at least another 18 years of chaos ahead of us. We can do this. I mean, if we can get through tonight, we can get through anything, right? It'll be good.
Too many people riding the creepy way. Every time I think of leaving you, and I sigh. Every time I think of your face, no turning back.
Hey. Hey.
Is Megan here?
Yeah, I just picked her up. You mind telling me what the hell you're doing coming back at this hour?
Totally screwed up. That rave, I mean, that wasn't even the worst mistake that I made tonight. I'm gonna save you the trouble of drowning me.
You know, Cam, it's really late, and I really don't feel like talking about this. Go to bed.
Got it.
You can't plan on a long discussion tomorrow.
Another 18 years? Smoking again?
No, not really smoking. I'm just sort of smoking.
Mom, it's been years. Why are you doing it again?
I don't know. Yeah, I guess. This last year, so many changes. You know, sometimes you feel better when you go back to old habits.
Oh, that is the worst excuse I have ever heard. Look, I don't like you smoking. But if you have to, please, please don't do it in the house, okay?
Look, it's an aberration. Now that you're pregnant, it's a great incentive. There.
Grandma, would you mind if I talk to Mom for a second?
Sure. Look, Megan, I'm really not in the mood for another fight, okay?
No, this isn't a fight, I promise. I know that there's not much I could say to explain last night. I don't even really get it myself.
That makes two of us.
Dad told me that the worst part of it was, I knew exactly what I was doing. I knew that you'd be worried. And he's right. And I'm sorry for that.
Well, I appreciate that you're sorry, and I accept your apology. Megan, I can't keep doing this. I mean, we fight and apologize, and nothing ever changes. You know, you still think that everything I do, everything I say has an ulterior motive.
You're right. It's like I've gotten so used to fighting with you. That I just fight for, like, no reason. We used to be different. I remember just wanting to talk to you about everything. And I want to be like that again. One good thing came out of last night. I'm sorry things got so out of hand. I can only imagine what my father said. Don't let him get to you.
I'm not really worried about him getting to me.
But I get to you.
Cameron, I'm sorry. I'm really sorry. I promise it'll never happen again. I swear.
Alicia, I can't help you, all right? But your dad
doesn't give a damn about me.
No, you're wrong, okay? You're all he cares about. All those things you said to me about him, that was a lie too, wasn't it? Because you just knew I would believe you.
No. He's crazy.
I'm so totally sorry.
Drive downtown to come and pick me up.
Actually, I didn't think about much past backing out of the driveway. And even that had about a 50-50 chance of success.
Well, thank you. And after, you know, I'm not grounded anymore and you're not grounded anymore, I'll take you out driving, I promise.
I came back for you last night.
I know. Thanks.
How's Alicia?
Oh, I don't know. I wish I could help, but there's no way. I'm just making it worse. So, I'm gonna make myself stay away.
You want me to get that?
No, just let it go. When the beep beeps, leave a message.
Hey, Megan. It's me, Clay. I wanted to make sure you're okay.
Cam,
got home and stuff. And
would you tell him I'm okay?
Well, I just wanted to talk to you.
Yeah, sure.
I don't know.
Hey, what's up, man? This is her brother. Yeah, she's good, but she's out. Yeah, I'll let her know you called. All right, man. Later.
Long story.
Last time I checked, we had a lot of free time on our hands.
I just want you to know I'm happy about the baby.
Thanks.
I just thought you should know.
Thanks. I'm glad I do.
Well, go on, honey. Let's run the names by the kids. Oh, see what they think.
Yeah? Okay. All right. So, what do you think of the name? Caitlin. No.
I don't think so. I told you.
You do it. You do it. All right. What about the name Callie?
I know a pony named Callie. Yeah.
You know, I don't think I know any Xenas. Well, except for that one.
Hey, Mom, how do you know it's going to be a girl anyway?
Sometimes a mother just knows.
She was convinced Kenny was going to be a girl.
Remember that?
Don't even go there.
Convinced.
I hope it's a girl too.